Hello students, today we will discuss P block elements. Yes, you know that periodic table is divided into four blocks, S, P, D, F. P block elements are those in which last electron enters in P orbital of outermost shell and its general configuration is NS2 NP1. P block consists of 6 groups, from group 13 to group 18. Group 13 has outermost configuration NS2 NP1, similarly 14 NS2 NP1 and so on. Clear? Then general electronic configuration and oxidation state. Yes, in group 13 the general configuration is NS2 NP1. 15 NS2 NP 14 NS2 NP2 15 NS2 NP3 16 NS2 NP4 17 NS2 NP5 and 18 NS2 NP6. Then metals and non-metals, metalloids, these all are present in P block. You all know that metals have bigger size, non-metals have small size and metalloids have intermediate size. Okay, so we all know that in group 13 the elements are boron, aluminium, gallium, indium and thallium. This is also called boron family. The non-metals have higher ionization energy and high electronegativity. This is because in period atomic size decreases. So we can say non-metallic character and electronegativity increases along the period. And in group size increases, so these properties are decreased. The compounds or the elements which have intermediate state behave as metalloids. Yes, because they show highest oxidation state due to their small size, so we can say they show sharing and other orbitals. For example, in case of aluminium, 3d orbital is also there, so aluminium can show 3s2 3p1 configuration. So aluminium can show maximum 6 surroundings because of the presence of vacant d orbitals. But in group 13, the stability of oxidation state of plus 3 decreases down. Yes, in case of 18 group, there is noble gases, so they show inert properties. But in case of group 13, they are highly reactive elements, but they are weaker non-metal than 14, 15, 16 and 17. The group 13 elements, boron, aluminium, gallium, indium and thallium. In group, atomic size increases from boron to thallium. But the size of gallium is smaller than aluminium. Why? Because of the presence of poor shielding effect of inner d orbitals. The first ionization energy of these elements are less than S block elements. Why? Because of the low penetration power, P orbitals lose electrons easily. But due to the presence of inner d orbitals and poor shielding effect, because the d orbitals have diffuse size, so they show poor shielding effect and more effective nuclear charge. Hence, along the group, S orbitals are not participated in bond formation. This is called inert pair effect. So along the group, plus 1 oxidation state becomes more stable than plus 3 oxidation state. Then come to the physical properties. Boron is very hard. Why? Because of its small size. And it also shows many allotropic form. What do you mean by allotropy? The allotropy means the existence of an element in more than one form. Density increases down the group because size because atomic mass increase. You all know that density equals to mass upon volume. If mass increases, density also increases, right? Then boron family show less metallic or less electropositive characters than previous groups. Why? Because of smaller size. But in group, metallic character increases. Why? Because size increases. Right? Oxidation state, the configuration, although the because the configuration in outermost shell is NS2NP1. So the journal oxidation state is +3. Then we come to chemical properties of group 13. Boron, electronic structure and chemical properties, it shows different properties than other element because of its small size. So in this group, boron is not a metal. Other are metals, but boron is non-metal because the size is very small. Then boron is used to make glasses, ceramics and agriculture. Aluminium is used in electrical devices. Why? Aluminium is used to make aircraft bodies because of its lighter weight and its twice conductivity than copper. It is good conductor, or it is used to make transmission cables. Then gallium is used to make amplifier, solar cells and satellites. Then now we come to the main or very important properties of boron. Due to its very small size, it needs very high ionization energy. So the sum of all three ionization energy is very high than other elements of this group. It does not show +3 oxidation state, but it shows 3 covalency. It means its outermost shell, 3 electrons are participated to make covalent bonds. And it is unreactive in crystalline form. It is also because of its very small size. On heating, it makes B2O3. It means oxides. But at low temperature, it is unreactive. It shows only or it forms only oxides and nitrides at very high temperature. Similarly, aluminium also make oxides easily. So due to this, aluminium is used to make transmission cables, because in the presence of air, aluminium makes a protective film of oxide on its surface. So it is resistant to corrosion. We all know that metallic character increases down the group. It means we can say the basic nature of oxide increases down the group. But boron is very smaller size, hence B2O3 is acidic in nature and it is highly resistant to acids and alkalis. In the other elements, due to the poor shielding effect of inner d and f electrons, the +3 oxidation stability decreases down. They show mainly +1 oxidation state. So for example, if the question is why +3 oxidation state the stability of +3 oxidation state decreases down the group, the answer is because of inert pair effect, as orbitals are not participated. Aluminium is highly reactive metal in this group, so aluminium also reacts with acids and base, and it is also amphoteric in nature. Then other groups than previous groups, then S and D block elements, aluminium is smaller in size, so its oxides show amphoteric behavior. What do you mean by amphoteric behavior? Amphoteric means the property which show acidic and basic group. Okay, then in this group, only aluminium and boron form oxides and nitrides. Then it means we can say the chemical properties of boron and aluminium are different than other elements of this group. Now we come to compounds of boron. The first compound is borax. Its formula is Na2B4O710H2O. It means it has 10 molecules of water which are added by the water of crystallization. Now the question is, what is the nature of borax? It is basic in nature. It is alkaline in nature because it dissolves in water to form alkali, which is NaOH, and that is very strong alkali. Borax is also used to detect cation present in salt by borax bead test. First of all, the platinum wire is dipped in compound and then borax, and it is heated. It gives colorful beads. This test is called borax bead test. Borax is heated to give a number of compounds. Then, for example, when borax is heated, then finally it is converted into B2O3 and it reacts with metal to give colorful metaborates. Its acid, it is boric acid, means borax is also converted into boric acid by hydrolysis. Boric acid, the formula is S3BO3. The name shows it is acidic in nature, but actually it does not release a cation of its own. Then reaction Na2B4O7, HCl and oxygen, it gives good yield of boric acid. It has layer structure in which BO3 units are held together by hydrogen bonds. Then boric acid, why boric acid is weak monobasic acid or monoproteic acid? The reason is because it is Lewis acid. So it accepts electron pair from water molecules and releases HIM. It accepts lone pair of electron from water molecule in the form of OH. So in water, it makes BOH whole 4 minus and it releases HIM. So what is the meaning of this? It does not release its own HIM. It releases the HIM of water. Now we come to a very important question. It is the heating effect of boric acid. First of all, one water molecule released from S3BO3, then it becomes converted into HBO2, then it is further heated to give B2O3. Now we come to hydrides of boron. Hydrides of boron are called borates, and out of all borates, the important borate is diborate, B2S6. We all know that in BS3, boron does not complete its octet. Why? Because it is non-metal and it shares only 3 electrons with 3 hydrogen atoms. Hence, it exists as in borates. For example, BS3 is converted into diborane by dimerization B2S6. Then the preparation of diborane, the reaction is BF3 and LiAlH4. It is converted into B2S6. The next and convenient method is we have to use sodium borohydride NaBH4 and I2. It is converted into B2S6. Now we come to properties of diborane. It is colorless and highly toxic gas, and it catches fire on exposure to air because it burns in air to release large amount of energy. It reacts with ammonia, and if we pass excess of ammonia, it is converted into a compound B3N3S6, which is called inorganic benzene or borazine. The structure of diborane is also very important. It has 6 hydrogens, and out of 6 hydrogens, 4 hydrogen atoms are terminal hydrogens and 2 hydrogen atoms are used as bridged hydrogen. Is this type of structure is called banana type structure. In this banana type structure, on the terminal bonds, there are 2 electron, 2 center atoms, but in bridge, there are 2 electrons and 3 center atoms. Right? Then, now we come to the other properties of boron. Boron has less density, less conductivity, less reactivity because of its very small size. And due to all these properties, it is used to make bulletproof waste. and light material for making aircraft bodies. The isotope of boron is B10, boron 10, which is used in nuclear reactor. It is used to slow down the speed of neutrons. So we can say it is used as moderator. The main industrial property of borax and boric acid are, these are used to make heat resistant glasses like glass wool and fiber glass. It is also used to make medicinal soap because the aqueous solution of orthoboric acid is very, very weak acid. So it is used to make for washing eyes during the problem of conjunctivitis. So due to its antiseptic property, boric acid is used to wash eyes. Then now we come to aluminium. We know that aluminium is smaller in size in its period than other metals. Like, so aluminium is weaker metal than other group metals. It is used to make alloy with copper, manganese, magnesium, silicon and zinc. Aluminium alloys are used to make pipe, tubes, rods, wires, plates of foils. Why? Because of its lighter in weight. Due to its lighter property, lighter mass property, it is used to make aeroplane and transportation industry. Then aluminium is also used to make domestic purpose because of its lighter in nature. For example, aluminium is also used to open the drainage pipe because it reacts with NaOH to release high pressure hydrogen gas, which is used to open the drainage pipe. Now, this group 13 is completed, is finished. Then now we start group 14 elements. Yes, group 14 is called carbon family. It consists of carbon, silicon, germanium, tin and lead. Why it is called carbon family? Because of its first element, carbon. Then these are typical non-metals because of their small size. But similarly, the other groups, metallic character also increases down the group. So we can say the last element, lead, is a metal. Carbon and silicon are non-metals. Germanium and tin are metalloids. And lead is the metal. Then now we come to the other properties, just like atomic mass, configuration, size, ionization energy, electronegativity and so on. Electronegativity decreases down the group, like other groups. The size increases, the attraction power decreases. So we can say in group electronegativity decreases down. So we can say carbon is most electronegative in this group. But the metallic character increases down the group. Now we come to oxidation states. They have 4 electrons in outer motion. So they should show plus 4 oxidation state. Carbon and silicon show plus 4 oxidation state. It doesn't mean that they lose the electron. It means they share 4 electrons. So we can say carbon and silicon show tetracovalency. But in group, metallic character increases down. And due to the presence of inert pair effect, due to the presence of inert d and f orbitals, the plus 4 oxidation state stability decreases down. They only participate the 2 electrons of p orbital. So we can say in group 14, plus 2 oxidation state become more stable than plus 4 oxidation state. The questions based on this topic is very, very important. For example, the question is PbCl4 is less stable than PbCl2. The answer is due to inert pair effect, plus 2 is more stable than plus 4 oxidation state. What is the meaning of catenation? Catenation means self-linkage. The atoms link together with other similar atoms. This is called catenation. Catenation depends upon 2 factors. Number 1, atomic size, and number 2, strength of bond. It means we can say in group, catenation property decreases down. So carbon shows greater tendency of catenation Number one, due to very small size. Number two, absence of lone pair of electron, C-C bond is stronger than other element-element bonds, than other group. For example, in case of nitrogen, oxygen and fluorine, due to the presence of lone pair of electron, there is more repulsion. So nitrogen, oxygen and fluorine, they do not show catenation easily, although they have smaller size. And carbon has more tendency to make multiple bonds also. It has a property to make double bond, triple bond and single bond because of its catenation property. But this property decreases down the group because of increasing atomic size. Then covalent hydrides like CH4, MH4. CH4 means carbon shares it 4 electrons. And carbon makes hydrides in the form of single bonds, double bonds and triple bonds. So we can say then carbon has the maximum property to show catenation in the form of multiple bonds also. But this property to make tetracovalency decreases down because of increasing atomic size and the inert pair effect. They show metallic property and plus 2 oxidation state is more stable. Then group 14 elements have also the good property to make oxides. We can say carbon or silicon has maximum property to form oxides. Then carbon has property to make carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide or other mixed oxide. For example, silicon, germanium also have the property to make mixed oxide. Mixed oxide means like monoxide and dioxide. All elements of group 14 except silicon form monoxide. Why silicon does not form monoxide? Because silicon has bigger size than carbon and smaller size than other elements. Carbon monoxide is neutral in nature, but carbon dioxide is acidic in nature. All the oxides of this group is basic in nature. Why? What is the reason? Because in group size increases, metallic character increases, and you all know that metal oxides are basic in nature. Group 14 have the elements to form dioxide like MO2. Now we come to form halite. Yes, thank you.